His rhythm is questionable, but David Seymour is increasingly in sync with voters.
Thank you very much.
At hitting 5%, up from just 1% this time last year.
I just get up and work hard for New Zealand.
A lot of the hard work he's done on issues like euthanasia and gun laws in recent months is paying off benefits.
The Greens right on the edge of the 5% danger zone.
We need to get out there and campaign and make sure that people know the value that we have added to the government.
New Zealand first on 2%. Its leader accusing the Greens of skullduggery for trying to overturn his waka-jumping law.
Can the Greens not be trusted, Mr. Peters?
Well, I pointed out that they voted for that bill. It was actually to preserve their own organisation, and then they have reneged on it.
Mr. Peters says trust is key.
Well, the public believe that when politicians get into Parliament, they should keep their word.
One News also polled Kiwis about their trust in party leaders. Jacinda Ardern well out in front, more than 80% trust her. Second is ex David Seymour, with the trust of almost half of those polled. Judith Collins polarising, voters split almost 50-50. The Greens co-leaders polling around the same. At the very bottom, the only political leader not trusted by the majority of voters, Winston Peters.
How about that?
He chooses his own behaviour and people have the option of judging him for that.
We asked voters today who they trust the most.
Judith, because she hasn't done anything wrong yet.
It would have to be Jacinda.
I have distrust in several of the national politicians. I won't name them, but they know who they are.
And do they trust Winston Peters?
Look, he's a lovely guy, but no.
He's had a good run and it's about time he probably looked for something else.
People vote for New Zealand First because of Winston Peters, you know, by and large. So if people don't trust him, if he's not connecting the electorate, then they're really going to struggle.
Mr. Peters has just 7 weeks to turn things around. Benedict Collins, One News.
All right, going back to Jess now, there's a bit of a difference between our poll and a poll released at the weekend. Why are we seeing that contrast?
Well, that Reed Research poll was taken right in the middle of Nationals carnage, and it was also taken over a longer period of time. This poll comes once everything has calmed down. But I think what both of those polls show is a bit of a trend, that Labor is going to be hard to beat. We have been polling consistently, and this is the fifth poll that we've done this year. What it shows is that Jacinda Ardern got a whole lot of support for her handling of COVID-19. We haven't really seen that drop away, so she's really going to play that up during the election campaign. But at the moment, a week is a very, very long time in politics.
Ain't that the truth? Kia ora, Jess. That's political editor Jessica Much-Mackay.